Now we have here the death of Joshua. Verse 29, it came to pass after these things that Joshua the son of Nun, the servant of the Lord, died, being 110 years old. And they buried him in the border of his inheritance in Timnath-Serah, which is in Mount Ephraim, on the north side of the hill of Gaash. And I've seen that, friends. As we said before, that Timnath-Serah is a pretty barren place. That's the worst place in that area up there, and it's a beautiful area, but believe me, this is not the place you'd want to choose. This is the land that Joshua had taken. Now, will you notice? And Israel served the Lord all the days of Joshua, and all the days of the elders that outlived Joshua, and which had known all the works of the Lord that he had done for Israel. And the bones of Joseph, which the children of Israel brought up out of Egypt, buried they in Shechem, in a parcel of ground which Jacob bought of the sons of Hamor. Now you see, Joseph was the father of the Ephraimites and Manasseh. And so when he had left commandment, we saw that in the book of Genesis, that when they came up out of the land of Egypt, they were to bring his bones, and they brought him for 40 years through the wilderness. Now they're to bury him in that land. Why? He's expecting to be raised from the dead someday in that land. And we're told that they buried him and the sons of Hamor, the father of Shechem, for 100 pieces of silver, and it became the inheritance of the children of Joseph, that is, of Ephraim and Manasseh. Now, verse 33, and Eleazar, the son of Aaron, died, and they buried him in a hill that pertained to Phinehas, his son, which was given him in Mount Ephraim. Now, here is the second high priest that dies, and another one will come on the scene. And Joshua, the leader that followed Moses, he dies now. This book is bounded with death. It begins with the death of Moses. It ends with the death here of Eleazar, and also, of course, the death of Joshua. And the thing that interests me here, though, is that they buried Eleazar in a hill that pertaineth to Phinehas, his son, which was given him in Mount Ephraim. And the question is, the priests were given no land. Yet here is a priest that acquired a nice little piece of real estate. You see, there is the beginning of that departure from the living and the true God. This is a tremendous book. I hope that you've learned to appreciate Joshua and also the tremendous thing that took place when the children of Israel came out of the wilderness and came into that land.